Japan invaded Manchuria, already studied Manchuria in 1937, and China and seized Beijing, capital of China. Then, in spite of all these manifestations of military activity by Germany, Italy, Japan, and Britain and France continued to be non-interventionist. The mood in Britain was not in favor of starting another war. Prime Minister Baldwin and Neville Chamberlain did not feel justified in interventing the region which was not officially in their sphere of interest. The United States were totally indifferent to the outside world and was concerned with the revival of economy after the Great Depression. Second lesson we studied, the Great Depression, economic depression, and that is already studied. Next one, Munich Pact. In 1938, Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain concluded the Munich Pact with Germany, which was a shameful expectation of Germany's invasion of Czechoslovakia to annex German-speaking Sudeten land. In 1939, the Soviet Union independently concluded a non-aggressive pact with Germany. The continued passivity of the Allies and the reluctance to start building up their armies were also contributory causes of the extent the scale of Second World War. See, Germany concluded treaty with Neville Chamberlain, Britain, and also treaty with Russia. But Hitler's policy was, first he will conclude a treaty. He accepted. And after short period, he would violate the policy. That was the way, Hitler's tacticism. So what did Hitler do? He broke the treaty concluded with Neville Chamberlain. That means it's a Munich Pact. And what did Hitler do? In 1939, he invaded Czechoslovakia. Poland was attacked next. And this was the final act which resulted in the declaration of war by Britain and France against Germany. In Britain, Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain resigned. By the 1940, Prime Minister of Britain resigned his post. What was the next? Winston Churchill came to power. So this was the situation. Now courses. What were the courses of the Second World War? The Second War was a modern war fought with heavy military equipment. They introduced so many modern technology used in the Second World War, like submarines, battleships, aircraft carriers, fighter planes and bombers planes. This involved a very large resource base. Now let us see outbreak of war. Britain and France declared war on Germany. See, first this is the Allied powers and Central powers. Understand? So Allied power this time, Allied power and Axis power. Axis power means Germany, Rome, Berlin, Tokyo Axis. So this time, First World War, Central powers and Allied powers. This time, Allied powers and Axis powers. So what was the reason? First, Britain and France attacked war on Germany in September 1939. That was the duration of the First World War starting year 1939, both the countries. In June 1940, Italy joined Germany. So when Germany was attacked by this one, it already they concluded a Rome, Berlin, Tokyo Axis. So Italy came to Germany's side. And in September 1940, Japan also joined. Understand, these were the Rome, Berlin attack. When one country was affected, another country would automatically came and helped. And that was the norms of the treaty. There was little action immediately after the declaration of war. Britain had already begun to build up its military capabilities. In 1941, all of the mainland Europe till the Russian frontier was under the Axis powers. So, beginning, the Axis powers were victorious, but ended, they were defeated by the Allied powers. So Germany followed the tactics of the attack lightning war, that is the lightning strike. That is, lightning strike is known as Blitzkrieg. to storm into various countries and overrun. It was the policy followed by famous Hitler. The British Royal Navy continued to be the most powerful among the European naval because Britain was an island, so they were very expert in naval power. The important event, Dunkirk. In May 1940, more than 3 lakhs British and French soldiers were forced back to the beaches in Dunkirk. So beginning the Central Power Simon era, the Axis powers were victorious. Germany was very victorious at the beginning. So it attacked Dunkirk. Next one, Battle of Britain. Germany attacked the capital city, London. And so many people were destroyed. German Air Force began to attack specific targets, especially in ports, airfields and industrial installations. In September 1940, London was bombed mercilessly, an action known as the Blitz, already known Blitz means lightning war. In October 1940, night bombing, see lightning war night time, so night bombing raids on London and other industrial cities began. This campaign failed because with the aid of newly developed and top secret device, radar for detecting aircraft while still at their distance, the fighter planes of the Royal Air Force, Spitfires and Hurricanes were able to inflict severe losses on the German bombers. The German dropped the plans to invade Britain because of the failure of air battle. By the simultaneously, America followed the Lend-Lease policy. At that time, President of America, Roosevelt, realized that the United States had to change its policy of isolation. So far, he followed the policy of isolation. Now, Roosevelt, he avoided that policy and he followed the new policy that is called the Lend-Lease policy. And what was the Lend-Lease policy? In 1941, arms, food, military equipment and other supplies were sent to Britain. America sent to all the help in the form of food, military equipment, everything. Who? During the time of Roosevelt. And between 1941 and 1945, the total aid under Lend-Lease amounted to 46.5 billion. Next, this is one side. Next one, invasion of Russia. German attacked Russia in 1941. But what a beginning, Germany was very victorious. But due to winter season, the Germans were defeated in this battle. The Germans then marched on Moscow, but ultimately the resistance by the Soviet army and the fierce Russian winter defeated the German army. Condition, unfavorable condition of winter season. Beginning they were very successful. Next one, Battle of Stalingrad. Stalingrad in Russia, 17th July 1942, 2nd February and 1943. In August 1942, the Germans attacked Stalingrad. And what happened? June 28, 1942, operation began with significant German victories. Russian people suffered not only from the bad working and living conditions, but also from ill treatment at German hands in the occupied areas. So there were about 15 million civilian deaths during the war and almost 10 million members of the armed forces were killed. Yet people of Stalingrad remained loyal to the government. Despite Hitler's hope of an anti-Stalin revolution, they successfully defended the city of Stalingrad in Russia. Next one, Battle of El Alamein, 1942. So after the Battle of Stalingrad, 42, El Alamein, German forces under General Rommel were remarkably attacked. They attacked North Africa rapidly, leaving the British with only Egypt. The Allied forces under General Montgomery counterattacked and defeated German and Italian forces at El Alamein in North Africa. So both the combined forces of Germany and Italy were defeated by Britain. The German army was chased across the desert. Africa, you know, desert. Out of North Africa, this provoked the base for the Allied powers to invade Italy. Then surrendered to Italy. So both the countries were defeated. 1943, the dictator Mussolini was the leader of the Italy. So Mussolini had been thrown out and the new government of Italy surrendered to the Allies in 1943. Germans set Mussolini up in a puppet regime in the north. Finally, when Italy was defeated by the Allied powers, Mussolini was shot dead by his own country people. So what happened? Italy was defeated. Next one, end of Hitler. Only German was, let us see, the European countries, Italy was defeated, the Mussolini was shot dead. Next, Germany, Hitler. The Allied forces under the command of General Eisenhower invaded Normandy in France. Slowly the German army was forced back. But the German fought back and the war continued for nearly another year and finally ended in May 1945. And what happened? Unfortunately, Germany was defeated by the Allied powers and Hitler could not tolerate. So what did Hitler do? He committed suicide. So Italy, Mussolini was shot dead. Here Hitler, when Hitler, Germany was defeated by the Allied powers, Hitler committed suicide. That only one country was left alone, that was Japan. War in the Asia Pacific region. So Europe, both that three axis, Rome, Berlin, Tokyo axis, Italy no more, Germany was no more. So only Japan was left. War in the Asia Pacific region. Japan had entertained visions of glorious empire, very much on the same lines as Hitler. So he followed the policy of Hitler. The Japanese army invaded Manchuria in 1931. Then they attacked China, already we studied. Finally, the Japanese army ended in the biggest slaughter ever known in history in Nanjing. Civilians were killed and masses for sport and all females. From children to old women were killed in the battle by the Japanese army. Then, after attacking China, then Japan turned its attention towards America. So, what did Japan do? It attacked Pearl Harbor. Which country? Japan. Pearl Harbor 1941. On December 1941, Japan attacked American naval installations in Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, without warning. The idea was to cripple American Pacific fleet so that Japan would not face any opposition in its offensive against Southeast Asian countries. So Japan planned like this. And what happened? Many battleships and numerous fighter planes were destroyed. So America did not keep quiet. So without any warning, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor. So what did America do? The United States declared war on Japan, with Britain and China also. So when USA attacked Britain, so the Allied powers, the Britain came with joined the America, and simultaneously China also joined. So the United States with enormous resources into the war as a party of Allies. Next, Japanese aggression in Southeast Asia. The Japanese had a spectacular success in their plans to extend their empire through Southeast Asia. Philippines, Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaya, the Dutch East Indies, I mean Indonesia and Burma, all fell into the hands of Japan. Then America did not keep quiet. When Japan was becoming more powerful, what did America do? America attacked Japan. This battle is known as Battle of Midway and Battle of Guadalcanal. The US Navy defeated the Japanese Navy in the Battle of Midway, which turned the tide in favor of the Allies. So far, Japan was very victorious. Understand, it attacked, captured so many countries. Attacked China, it defeated China, Manchuria, and attacked the Pearl Harbor. So, the opportunity turned to the Allied powers. The Battle of Guadalcanal in the Solomon Island. In the Solomon Island was a combined offensive involving the army and the navy and lasted for several months. Both were crushing defeats for Japanese. After this, the American forces were able to retake the Philippines. They were able to. So many countries were under the control of Japan, Philippines, Malaya, Singapore, Hong Kong. So Japan, America got the place of Philippines. Gradually, the Japanese were thrown out of most of their conquered territories. Now, the condition was favorable to the Allied powers, particularly America. In 1944, the combined British and Indian armies, mind you, we were under the control of the British force. So, India was also helping Britain. So, our forces also helped Britain, Allied powers. And finally, America dropped the atom bombs on Japan, important Hiroshima, first time it dropped the atom bomb in Hiroshima and next to Nagasaki. Two important cities of Japan were crushed. Then August 15th, it was as a top secret project using the latest scientific advances, the US developed an atomic bomb, immediately more powerful than conventional explosive. The Japanese generals refused to surrender. So America got angry. So he took a modern technology atom bomb, one at Hiroshima, another one at Nagasaki. So completely devastated. On 15th August 1945, Japan signed, then which came to the end of the Second World War. So these were the came to the end of the Second World War, duration 1939 to 1945. Japan was thoroughly, two important cities were thoroughly destroyed by the atom bomb used by the US. Now what was the effects of the war? What was the effects? The Axis were completely destroyed. So two superpowers came into being. One was Russia, another one was America. The nuclear proliferation, the United States and the Soviet Union entered into a race to have more nuclear power weapons. So, America followed the capitalist communist policy and Russia followed the communist policy. So, two superpowers emerged after the Second World War. See, Central powers, Allied powers, which two countries became powerful after the Second World War? One is America, another one is Russia. Now, they are waiting for Cold War. They were demanding some countries to be joining with their countries. Another, America was expecting to have more territories and signing treaties with other countries, but India not for joining either of these two superpowers. What was the result of the Second World War? Two superpowers emerged, but India did not join either this America or Russia. So we are following non-intervention policy. So this was the result of the Second World War. Next one, let us see Holocaust. What is the meaning of Holocaust? It was the Hitler's aggressive policy. Hitler also, he hated Jews, understand? He used genocide and Jews were persecuted. Jews were thoroughly, people were affected by the aggressive policy of Adolf Hitler. He hated Jews, understand? So what? He persecuted Jews and confiscated the territory. This was the policy followed by Adolf Hitler, that is the Holocaust and its fallout. Then what was the result of the Second World War? First World War, League of Nations was set up. Second World War, UNO, United Nations Organization was set up. Next, New International Order. By 1941, United States and Britain began to give serious consideration to need for international cooperation for achieving lasting peace among all nations. International economic and financial stability were also important objectives. All this would need international organization with members of the various nations across the world working together for the common objectives. This ultimately resulted in the establishment of United Nations. So, what are the branches of United Nations? United Nations specialized agencies, World Health Organization, International Labour Organization, International Monetary Fund, World. These are the specialized organization of United Nations organization. And what is the aim of United Nations organization? UNO still existing. What is the aim of United Nations? To the same thing to prevent war in future, to maintain international peace and harmony in the world. Next, what are the organs? So, United Nations was accepted by all the 26 countries which were fighting against the Axis power. Who were the Axis power? Germany, Italy and Japan. On New Year's Day 1942, the Charter of United Nations was signed. 51 nations, India, which was not an independent country, then also was signatory to the charter. Now the United Nations has 193 member states, and each one bigger small, has an equal vote in the United Nations. UN is still existing. Then what was the organs? First one, important, General Assembly and Security Council. You already seen the as usual in the League of Nations. The United Nations function almost like a government through its principal organ, which are similar to the legislative, executive and judicial wings. In the General Assembly is the body in which each member state is represented. It means once a year, so it means once in a year, and issues of interest on points of conflict are discussed in the assembly. Next one, Security Council, 15 members, 5 countries, the United States, Britain, France, Russia and China are permanent members of the Security Council, and there are 10 temporary members who are elected in the rotation. These 12 bodies function like a legislature. Each of the permanent members has the right to vote. 5 permanent members already, they have right to vote. And also they have the veto power. Veto means negative vote. This right has often been used to block major decisions, especially by the superpowers, the US and Russia. Then administrative sector, the executive wings of the United Nations is the UN Secretariat. It is headed by the Secretary General, who is elected by the General Assembly on the recommendations of the Security Council. The Secretary General, along with the Cabinet and other officials, runs the United Nations organization. The International Court of Justice, headquarters at The Hague in Holland, is the judicial wing of the United Nations. So it is the judicial organ, the International Court of Justice, located in Hague in Holland. The Economic and Social Council, ECOSOC, the fifth organ of the United Nations, is responsible for coordinating all the economic and social work of the United Nations. The Regional Economic Commissions functioning for regional development across the various regions of the world, Asia Pacific, West Asia, Europe, Africa and Latin America, are organs of ECOSOC. They have been very successful. Then other important organs of the UNO, associated organization, deal with areas of critical interest to the world at large, like food, health and education and culture. These are Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, World Health Organization, WHO, UNESCO, United National Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. There are also special organizations funded voluntarily by member countries. The two best known among them are UNICEF, means United Nations Children's Fund, which promote children's health and welfare across the world, and UNDP, United Nations Development Program, which focuses in development. Then what are the activities of UNO? Over the decade, the United Nations has expanded its activity in response to the changing problems facing the world. Thus, in 1960, decolonization was an important issue. Human rights, the problems of refugees, climate change, gender equality, all are now within the ambit of activities of the United Nations. A special mention must be made of UN, which has acted in many areas of conflict all over the world. Now UN was settling so many problems at the sea. Next one, World Bank. The World Bank and the International Monetary Fund, referred to as the Bretton Woods Twins, were both established in 1949. This is very important one, 1945. After the Bretton Woods Conference in 1944, located in Washington, D.C. in the United States. They have the same membership since a country cannot be member of the bank without being a member of the fund. The two main organs of the World Bank are the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, IBRD, and the International Development Agency, IDA. Together, they are often referred to as the World Bank. The main responsibility of the IBRD in the initial years was to fund the reconstruction activities under the Marshall Plan in the European countries devastated by the war. The agenda later expanded to promote economic development in poorer countries. Next one, International Monetary Fund. The International Monetary Fund was primarily the brainchild of Harry Dexter White and John Maynard Keynes, the famous economist. It was formally organized in 1945, end of the Second World War, with 29 member countries. It is now has the membership of 189 countries. Its primary objective is to ensure financial stability and development across the world through international monitoring at national and international level. The fund lends money from its resources to countries facing balance of payments problems. Next one, what are the objectives of the IMF? In the box answer, the objective of International Monetary Fund are to foster global monetary cooperation, secure financial stability, facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and reduce poverty around the world. Then post-war welfare state in Europe. The term welfare state refers to the concept that the government is responsible for the social and economic welfare of the people. In 1942, the report commonly known as the Beveridge Report was published in United Kingdom, which proposed a series of measures which the government should adopt to provide citizens with adequate income, health care, education, housing and employment to overcome poverty and disease. After the war, Labour Party was voted to power in Britain. It promised to undertake steps to look after the people from the cradle to the grave, from the cradle, from birth to death. That is the meaning of cradle to the grave. Legislation was enacted to provide comprehensive free health coverage to the citizens through the National Health Service. The benefits can either be achieved through cash transfers like the old age pensions and unemployment compensation, or through free services, etc. In addition, these countries also try to minimize economic disparity. Disparity means differentiate. Understand, all are, that is meaning all are equal. No countries rich or poor. The higher income group at relatively high rate. So, this lesson so far we have studied the Second World War, course of the Second World War, results of the Second World War, importance of UNO, United Nations organizations, its organs, everything you study. So, you study all the glossary. Choose the correct answer. When did the Japanese formally sign up their surrender? Option A, 2nd September 1945. Who initiated the formation of League of Nations? Option C, Woodrow Wilson. Where was the Japanese Navy defeated by the US Navy? Option B, Battle of Midway. Where did US drop the first atomic bomb? Hiroshima. First one Hiroshima, second one Nagasaki. Who were mainly persecuted by Hitler? Jews. Option D. Which Prime Minister of England who signed the Munich Pact with Germany? Neville Chamberlain. Full name Neville Chamberlain, but here it is given Chamberlain. Where was the Charter of the UN signed? When was the Charter of the UN signed? Option B, June 26, 1945, because the end of the war. Fill in the blanks. First one, Hitler attacked Rhineland, which was demilitarized zone. The alliance between Italy, Germany and Japan is known as Rome-Berlin-Tokyo Axis. President Roosevelt started the Lend-Lease policy. Who brought the Lend-Lease money? President Roosevelt. Britain Prime Minister Chamberlain resigned in 1940, underline word Chamberlain. Dash is a device means radar, R-A-D-A-R. Choose the correct statement. Assertion: President Roosevelt realized that the United States had to change its policy of isolation. That's correct. A reason he started a program Lend-Lease. That also correct. So, option A, both A and R are correct. Next one, match the following. Blitzkrieg, Royal Navy, Lend-Lease, Volga, Guadalcanal. Roosevelt, Stalingrad, Solomon Island, Britain and Lightning Strike. Answer 3, 4, 5, 2, 1. Answer the question briefly. Who were the three prominent dictators of the post-World War? Page number 28. Post-war crisis last time. Italy of Mussolini, Germany of Hitler and Spain Franco. This is the answer for the first question. Then how did Hitler get the support from the people of Germany? Page number 28. Heading, the rise of Adolf Hitler. The full paragraph. Next one, describe the Pearl Harbor incident. Page number 32. Pearl Harbor, heading itself, 1941. Full paragraph. On December, that one too. Was a part of the Allies. Up to full paragraph, that is the answer for this question. What do you know of Beveridge report? Page number 36. Post-war welfare, that's the second paragraph. In 1942, the report commonly known as the Beveridge report, full paragraph to general welfare. That paragraph is the answer for this question. Then name the Bretton Woods twins. Bretton Woods twins, page number 35. The World Bank and the International Monetary Fund refer to as the Bretton Woods twins. This is the answer. Were both established in 1945 after the Bretton Woods Conference in 1944. That is the answer for this question. What are the objectives of IMF? IMF means International Monetary Fund. That's box answer, page number 36. The objective of IMF. That is the answer for the sixth question. Then answer in detail. Analyze the effects of the World War. Second, page number 33. Effects of the title, effects of the war, up to colonial powers were posted below above the Holocaust page. That up to that one, this is the answer for the detailed question. Assess the structure and activities of the UNO, page number 35. Activities of UNO, see that page number fully. Assess the structure and activities of UNO. Structure, what is the UNO? Administrative structure. From that one, administrative structure, from that to up to activities of the UNO, full paragraph, you are expected to study. So map, you see the map name, Axis power, Allied powers. Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Hawaii Island, Moscow, San Francisco, let us see it later. So students, you are expected to copy in your lesson note and detail, you write the question and need not write the answer by refer the page number. So thank you, one and all.